Welcome, welcome to a special video here on my channel. As you might know, a few months ago I bought a 3D printer and started to make ant nests. Well, it was kinda obvious I had a 3D printer. Anyway, I put some nests up for sale and to my surprise, this went really well. I sold a lot of nests now, all around the world. Italy, France, Germany, UK, and yes, even to America. I know what you're thinking. EA, aren't you swimming in money right now? The answer to that is no. In complete honesty, I haven't made any dollar in profit yet, but that's okay. In time, that will come. I would like to tell you a bit more about the products I'm making. I hear you thinking, is this video just gonna be a giant ad for your shop? Well, yes. The first products I sold were called the Series 1 nests. Series because I had three sizes, a small, medium and large nest. For a first design, these nests are really good and work pretty well. Some customers have ants in their nests already. And I can only say, it looks absolutely beautiful. A lot of people ask me how does hydration work on my nests, since my design concept is very unique and not standard in the ant keeping market. Usually, horizontal hydration is a no-go in 3D printed nests. Yet, I made it work. I use a very fine mesh to separate the ants from the sponge, meanwhile allowing humidity to spread through the nest. This mesh is very fine and I can guarantee no ants can escape since the holes are smaller than 0.5 mm. By using a hydration hole in the back of the nest, you can easily hydrate the nest without removing a shield or cover. Because the watering hole is in the back wall of the nest, the humidity in the nest stays much more stable. The sponges that I use are made from special foam that hold water extremely well. So far, none of my customers had any issues with hydration. You might be wondering, what about overflowing? Overflowing this nest with water is very hard to do. In theory, every nest can be flooded, but I made it extra hard. By implementing very deep water reservoirs, the small nest can hold 3 mm of water. That's 3 large pipettes of water before overflowing. Now let's talk about the new nests that are available in the shop. Because they are upgraded from the original nests, they are now called the Series 1.1 nests. The biggest new feature on these nests are the screws. I used to glue all my plates to the 3D printed piece. This was not only a hassle for me, but also for people that want to reuse the nest. You can still remove the plate, but then you have to re-glue it. The screws secure the plate, and when your colony is done with the nest, you can remove the plate and use the nest again. All nests will have an included Allen key to remove the screws. Another big change I made to the nest is an external connector. Thanks to customer feedback, I found out that they had a problem with connecting the nests to their existing setups. I made a revolutionary design that allows you to connect 9mm and 14mm tubing to the nest. And yes, even test tubes can be connected. Pretty genius if I say so myself. You can also choose if you want the lid for your nest. This is optional. Also, a new option in the store are customizable lids. You can have your name, logo or species engraved into the lid. Pretty cool, right? Enough about the nests. Let's move on to the other items I'm offering. If you see in my last video, that you can check out here, you might have seen my new mini Outworlds. Let me tell you, this thing is awesome. Personally, I don't like feeding ants in test tubes. It gets messy and sometimes ants can escape. Here is the solution. A small outworld with the option to connect two test tubes. You might be asking, hey EA, why two test tubes? Well, if one test tube dries out, or the other one gets too dirty, you can easily connect the new one. If you don't need it, you can plug up the hole with a small piece of cotton. Be advised that this outworld is an extension of your test tube and only serves for the founding process. If your colony reaches 50 to 100 workers, you should move them into a new nest with a proper outworld. Talking about outworlds, they are currently in development. Here you can see a tiny prototype I'm working on. I'm trying to make a large, affordable outworld that will complement my nests. I hope they will be available within a month or two. Alright, we will end with talking a bit about some accessories I offer. Let me tell you, there are a lot of accessories. Most of them are self-explanatory, so I suggest you check them out in my shop. Link is in the description. I want to end the video by saying a big, big thank you to everyone who watched this video and all the people that bought a nest from me. I think the future is looking very bright and I have so much more nest ideas I want to execute. On a final note, some people told me they want to support me but can't afford a nest. To those people I want to say, you are already supporting me so much by watching this video. You don't need to buy anything to earn my appreciation, because I appreciate each and every one of you. In the next few minutes, I'm showing some nice shots of the products with some extra information if you want to stay tuned for that. If you want to go now, thank you so much for watching this video.